हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम आरती नाइक। वेलकम इन ईरा ट्यूटोरियल्स। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑलरेडी आई हैव टॉट यू क्लास 10th सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश यूनिट 1 टॉपिक 1.2 स्टोरी द थीव्स ऑफ द थीव स्टोरी ऑलरेडी इट इज़ टॉट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वर्कशॉप। सो लेट अस सी इंग्लिश वर्कशॉप। दिस इज़ फॉर क्लास 10। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कम्प्लीट द वेब। इन दैट two questions are asked, Anil's virtue and Hari's vices. So what were Anil's virtues? So Anil was very simple. So here you can write down, he was simple, honest, kind and learned. That were the virtues of Anil. So what were the Hari's vices? Virtues means good quality, moral quality, and vices means bad habit. Okay, so which were the Hari's vices? First, undetected, he was liar, he was thief. Then he was insincere in his work, also he was cunning. So out of this, any four you can write down. Question number 2, insert the appropriate word phrase given below in the sentence that follows. So here options are given to you. You have to select appropriate option and write down the complete sentence. First one, I dashed to the school gate when I heard the school bell ring. Second, after the death of my pet dog, my spirits rose when Dad got me a new pup. Third, do not stoop to flattery just to gain something from someone. Do not stoop means do not accept or do not start with something which is not good, not the correct way. The artist completes his paintings by fits and starts. That means artist does not have any irregularity in making his paintings. The crime went undetected for 11 years. Last, when the baby saw his mother, it gave an appealing smile. So, dear students, if you know the meaning of these phrases, it will be easy for you to write down correct answer. Okay, let us see next. So, in next question, question number 3, find from the text the collocations of the following. So, before finding this, let us understand what is collocations. So collocations are the words that frequently occur together are called collocations. That means few words are there which are occurred frequently. Okay. For example, in greetings we say happy birthday, merry Christmas, but we do not interchange them. We do not say birthday happy, Christmas merry. Okay. Or good morning, morning good. So these words are already in one fashion and we do not change its sequence. So the nouns Christmas and birthday go with the adjective merry and happy respectively. These are called collocations. That means proper word should go with another to give something meaningful. So collocations are not formed on the basis of any rule, but by frequent occurrence of certain words together, it came into practice. Okay, so that is collocation. For collocation, for making collocation, rules are not there, but how we are using it, how it is in fashion, accordingly we copy it or we make it. But there is difference between compound words and collocations. So what are the compound words? Because in this lesson, in this workshop, compound words are also asked. So a compound word is one that is made up of two or more words. For example, the words teapot. Teapot is made up of the words tea and pot. If you separate this word, tea is different, pot is different, and teapot is something more different from these two. Okay. So compound words can be made with different rules. First is noun plus noun, that is sportsman, both words are noun. Second, gerund plus noun, That means first word you are using gerund and second is noun. For example, launching pad. Third, noun plus gerund. That means first you are using noun and adding gerund to it. That is bookbinding. Next, fourth one is adjective plus noun. That means first you are using adjective and then noun. Small talk, cold ice cream. And last is participle plus noun. That is drinking water, punching bag. So first you are using participle and then using noun. Okay, now let us see examples, questions from the workshop. Find from the text collocations for the following. Now in this text, in your lesson, already these collocations are given. You have to just find out the matching for it. Okay, so dog is given stray dog. Man is given greedy man. Ticket office, walked slowly. Light drizzle, whole sentence. Rose spirits. So here question may be asked, whenever you are asked a passage for comprehension, in that this type of questions may be asked for 1 mark or 2 mark, you have to identify the collocations from the given text. Okay, so whatever matching is given to you in the text, that only you have to use it. Now complete the compound words from the story. So here in story, which compound words are given, that exactly you have to write down. Oil rich, 50 rupee, easy going, clock tower, moonlight. These are the compound words. Okay, now pick out from the story 3 to 4 examples of code mixing. That means Indian words are used in English. So in this story we can see the words bazaar, maidan, pyjamas. These are the Indian words but used in English, because these words are accepted in English, and this type of use of this word is known as code mixing. Next, question number 4. Read the story carefully and complete the table. Now here, about Anil and Hari, you have to describe. That means whatever is asked in the table, accordingly you have to complete the table. So age, what is the age of Anil? 25. Physical appearance, how Anil is looking like? He is tall, lean, with a clear, unlined face. Okay. How he earn money? Writing for magazines and books. So which qualities does Anil have? Anil is kind, simple, easygoing, pleasant, forgiving and tactful. Hari. Now what is the age of Hari? Hari is 15 years old. His description, he is thin with many scars on the faces. And how he used to earn money? Stealing and cheating people. Which qualities does Hari have? Hari is cunning, insincere, untruthful, ambitious, grateful and shrewd. Okay, shrewd means skillful or tactful. With idea he is using, ideas he is applying in his profession. Okay, question number 7. Write a character sketch. Question number 4, 5 and 6 are also there, but first we will discuss 7. Write the character sketch of Hari Singh with the help of the following points. Now here you have to make a paragraph. A paragraph about Hari Singh. So Hari Singh's background. What is the background of Hari Singh? Hari Singh does not have parents. He does not have any family. He is alone and he is a very expert thief at the age of 15. He is thin and with many scars on his faces. And he used to cheat the people. About his dishonesty, what you will write? He is very dishonest. He just trying to looking after the people so that he can rob them, he can cheat them and can gain money. What is his aspirations? So he want to become an expert robber or expert thief in his life, and for that only he want to learn numbers and he want to learn full sentences, whole sentences. His courage to change himself. So when he robbed the when he robbed Anil, at that time he realized that it does not make any difference to Anil. In fact, Anil helped him in many ways and he was always ready to teach him so many things. And that thing become the turning point in his life. A very good nature of Anil help Hari Singh to turn into a good person. Okay. Now, question number 5. Complete the given sentences. Anil kept Hari as a cook because he wanted someone to cook for him. He perhaps also felt sorry for Hari. That means he was feeling very sorry for Hari, that Hari does not have anyone or he does not have any skills so that he can earn money. Hari was grateful. Why Hari was grateful? Because Anil was teaching him to read, write and add numbers, and all these would be useful to him in his life. Hari continued making money. How he continued making money? By cheating Anil while buying the day's supplies. Anil didn't hand Hari over to the police. So why he don't hand him to the police? Anil was probably too kind-hearted to hand Hari over to police. He might also have thought that he could try to make an honest man of Hari. That means Anil tried that if suppose Hari will be given any punishment, that will make him more worse rather than treating him with love, can change Hari Singh also. As he was kind-hearted, he thought that much about the Hari Singh. So, moral of the story is that if we are good, people are good to us in return. Even thieves respect goodness and kindness. Kindness, that is the important thing. That means from this story we learn that if we are good to others, definitely in return we are going to get good things. Question number 6. Think and write in your own words in your notebook. Why did Anil employ Hari as a cook although he could not afford to pay him? Anil employ Hari as a cook because Anil thought that whatever he is earning that was not enough, but he thought at least he can give food to Hari Singh and he can teach something good to Hari Singh so that in future he can start earning. What did Hari learn from Anil in the beginning? Hari learned from Anil first cooking. Anil taught him how to cook and how to make words. See, why didn't Anil hand over Hari to the police? What effect would it have on Hari? Anil did not hand over Hari to the police because he thought that if Hari is a child, Hari is the age of only 15, so his mind can be changed with goodness. So Anil tried to give him good treatment so that Hari can change his mind and he can be a good person in the life. But if Hari will be hand over to the police, in that case police will give him very worse treatment, which may change Hari to more which may change Hari into more bad conditions. Next, do you feel Anil's way of handling a thief like Hari was effective? Justify your answer. Yes, definitely. I think that Anil's way of handling a thief like Hari was really effective, because with love we can change the world. With love and care we can change the thinking of people also. Next question. What tact had Anil used to change Hari's dishonest way? Though Anil was knowing that Hari has cheated him, he did not make it realize to Hari that he is knowing everything about Hari, and that gave good impression on Hari. And Anil used to give him help, he used to take care of him, He used to teach him so many things, and that goodness of Anil changed Hari. It changed Hari's dishonest way. Last question. And the smile came by itself without any effort. Say why. Now when Hari met to Anil at that time, he laughed because he smiled. He gave appealing smile. Why? Because he want to increase interaction between Anil so that he can easily cheat him. Okay, he want to become more friendly with Anil. But at the end of the story, when Anil gave him money and he told him that now every month he is going to pay him something, so at that time Hari realized his mistake and he tried to become a changed person, and that feeling gave a smile. Because of that feeling, a smile came, and that smile came without any effort, because at that time Hari was what actually he was behaving, and exactly same he was. Okay, so when do people give fake smiles? When they want to take their work from someone, and for that they need some efforts. At that time they used to give fake smiles. Okay, question number 8, 7 already we had discussed, that is character sketch of Hari Singh. Question number 8, frame WH questions to get answers underlined below. So here students, you have to always alert to find out whatever part is underlined. Okay, I hurried back to the room. Now underline part is to the room. So I want answer to the room. For what? For I have to make question like that. Where did I hurried back? So you will get answer to the room. Next, I had made a study of men's faces. Okay, so here I want answer study of men's faces. So what study did I made? What study did I made? I had made a study of men's faces. Next, I drew them out without a sound. So here I want answer without a sound. So how did I drew them out? So I drew them out without a sound. Next, the poor man showed acceptance. Now I want answer the poor man. So who showed acceptance? I made tea in the morning. When did I made tea in the morning? Okay, so whenever you used to write this type of question, don't forget to put question mark after making your question. Okay, question number 9, imagine that Anil catches Hari red handed. When Hari is stealing the money from under the mattress, compose a short dialogue between the two which reflects Anil's shock and Hari's response over it. Okay, Hari's repeated apologies over it. Now Hari's repeated apologies means what? In this dialogue, you have to show that Anil come to know that Hari is cheating to him, and Hari try to apologize for it, that it was his mistake. So like that dialogue you have to make. Okay, next, this is how to frame WH question. As question is asked in this lesson, that prepare WH questions for underline part. So here, which WH words are there and what is the purpose of this WH word? Let us see in short. Who is used to identify person or persons? What is used to identify a thing or things? Which is used to identify people or things? Whose is used to identify the possessor? When is used to inquire about time? Why is used to asking for a reason or reasons? Where is used to inquire about a place? And whom is used to identify a person. How is used to elicit some information. Okay. So, in this way, you can use this WH word according to its function. So, lastly, thank you for attending my lecture sincerely. I hope that everybody might have understood the workshop what we have discussed today. Kindly subscribe my channel to get daily updates, and don't forget to click on bell button so that whenever I am going to upload the new video, immediately you will get information about it. Okay, thank you.